This segment in the Soil Health, a Montana Perspective video series will discuss one of the tools that agricultural producers can use to improve soil health. This tool is high stock density grazing. High stock density grazing is a management tool for tame pastures where the pasture consists of introduced plant species. These tame pastures may be dry land or irrigated. This system is designed so that the number of head of livestock per unit area is significantly increased for the purpose of improving soil health and boosting animal performance. Livestock are confined to small areas of pasture, generally with portable electric fence, for very short time periods. These time periods may even be as short as one day. High stock density grazing works on the premise that animal behavior changes when livestock are confined to very small pastures and are frequently moved to a new, fresh pasture. This tool of grazing management closely mimics the natural bunching behavior of wild herbivores under pressure by pack hunting predators. It was the main driver for creating the deep, fertile soils of the North American prairies. Under high stock density grazing, since livestock are given a small area to graze, they have a dramatic impact on the pasture environment in numerous ways. First, livestock tend to graze plants more evenly and graze a greater proportion of available plants. This greatly reduces the number of plants that are severely grazed, as may occur in standard rotational grazing systems. Because not as many plants are severely grazed, plant recovery periods shorten. The pasture is available to be regrazed sooner, thereby increasing potential yield. Since a greater proportion of plants are being grazed, both highly palatable and less desirable species are grazed. This helps to increase pasture biodiversity while reducing the presence of many noxious weed species.
In fact, one of our fields, it had so much hound's tongue or beggar's lice that you could make bales of hay out of it. Now in that field, you'll be hard-pressed to find one or two of those plants.
Greater pasture biodiversity is an asset to the rancher because different plants have varying levels of nutrients resulting from different rooting depths. Plant roots take up not only water, but also numerous minerals necessary for healthy, productive livestock. Secondly, since livestock are confined to a very small area for a very short time, animal distribution is more even over the entire pasture. This evenness of distribution allows urine and dung to be spread evenly and deposited at much greater densities than on fields grazed in a traditional rotation. In addition, up to 50% or more of the standing plant material may be trampled and incorporated into the soil surface to cover bare ground and feed soil biology. Soil biology, like earthworms and dung beetles, thrive where there is plenty of dung and dead plant material for them to live on. These small organisms incorporate this material into the soil, where it can eventually be recycled and converted into soil organic matter or made available to plants for future growth and development. As soil organic matter increases, available water holding capacity of the soil also increases, making plants more resilient to periods of low precipitation. Thirdly, livestock grazing at high stock densities and being moved frequently onto fresh ground experience a more constant level of nutrition. A more even level of nutrition allows livestock to not only be healthy, but more productive, as they are generally eating only the most nutritious part of the plant and are not forced to eat less palatable plant material. We have all seen overgrazed pastures in which the plants were either continuously grazed to very low stubble heights or were so mature that livestock ignored them. Fields in this condition suffer from very low stock densities. At very low densities, livestock have continual access to plants for extended periods of time. Often, the productivity of these fields continues to drop or remains at a subsistence level as highly palatable and highly productive species are replaced by lower growing and less productive species that have shorter rooting depths. This translates into lower stocking rates, less nutritious plants for livestock, the proliferation of less desirable plants that are less capable of handling periods of drought stress, and an increase in the amount of bare ground.
Earthworms, dung beetles, and other underground livestock such as fungi and bacteria are highly dependent on animal manures and trample plant residues for food sources. Additionally, bacteria and fungi feed the plant root zone for excess sugars and amino acids that are produced by the plant roots.
Plants grazed very low to the ground and not allowed a sufficient recovery period eventually lose root mass. This allows fewer sites for exchange with soil microbes. In stark contrast, high stock density grazing works because it focuses on feeding the innumerable underground livestock that feed the plants that feed the above ground livestock and wildlife species. Recovery periods are timed to allow full plant recovery on the most severely grazed plants. Full plant recovery allows the root system to remain healthy and vigorous or even increase in size over time. Increasing plant root mass provides more potential area for soil biological activity, stimulating both the microbes and the plants. While this grazing tool requires some additional labor to move animals more frequently with more vigilant monitoring of pasture conditions, the rewards of increased forage production, improved animal performance, and lower supplement costs can make it worth the effort.
Production doubled in the very first year. It doubled again the second year. There's not a person on this planet that could talk me out of the advantages of intensive grazing.
For more information about soil health and high stock density grazing, visit your local USDA service center or go to www.nrcs.usda.gov.